Hi, John here. This video is going to cover our home energy performance for our solar, battery, wind, turbine, cars, blah, 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 for the last 3 months, so October 2023 through to December 2023. And that also neatly fits into a year-end review as well. So I'll cover some stats in this video too. I'm not planning to do anything on the air source heat pump specifically in terms of stats and what have you, as I've just released a video on that. So I'll put a link in the top corner. You can go and click on that if you want to know a bit more about that. Here's our specs, our layouts, whatever you want to call it. I thought it'd be interesting just to have a quick look at what the Met Office says about the UK. So second warmest year on record for the UK. I'm not going to go through all of these charts in detail. I'll put a link to it down below. Hottest June on record. You can see there the mean temperature across the year, but also scroll down, you can also see a wet year for many with 11% more rain on average, which is quite interesting. And then it goes into December stats, which I'll skip through. But it's a useful piece of information there and data set. So how do we get on closer to home? First off, with Ripple Energy, our Crag Faffa wind turbine. Here are the monthly savings since go live. It was actually in March 2022, but the first saving was paid in April, so I'm just sort of showing it as April. So to date, we have achieved almost £1,300 in savings, which is a 50% return on investment in just under 23 months. Helped tremendously by this year's 2023's price point for a kilowatt of electricity. It was 27 pence a kilowatt paid to us, whereas in the first year it was 9 pence. In 2024, it's 6.55 pence, so a little bit more realistic. And we did benefit from the energy crisis. This is a comparing our electricity, monthly electricity costs versus the savings from a Ripple. And you can see there, in a lot of cases, it matched, outperformed the electric. And again, year on year, if you take it over the course of the year, it certainly has outperformed our electricity costs. If you recall, we're off gas now. Gas was stopped in July 2023. Here's solar for you. So the last 3 months we were concentrating on, I'm not going to read through all the figures because it gets a bit dull, plus they're actually on screen. But a typical picture of reducing solar generation. October was pretty good actually, 472, matched October 2021 almost. Well, in fact, it beat it, didn't it? 437 versus 472. And December, although it felt dismal, was actually very good in comparison to, as you'll see in a minute when we look on the years, year on years. This was the combined split across the two arrays, the 2.34 and the original 4 kilowatt array. Fairly standard stuff. The zeros there, for those that haven't been following along, is when we had 4 months where we had a 2.34 array down because of a fault on the optimizer on one of the back of the panels, took the whole array down. This chart looks at the combination of self-power from solar and the Tesla Powerwall battery in percentage terms. So what was the percentage of self-power of all of our energy needs for the home? These are the individual months going back to 2011 for firstly October. And you see there October was actually very good. It's our highest month ever in solar production. It is a very different picture depending on where you live in the UK. Because some people suffered with more cloud and rain, but we did quite well. And similarly with November, if you look at that there, to 335, some streets ahead of any of the other months. and December. Not the worst, certainly, but sort of middle of the road in terms of monthly performance. Middle of the road, perhaps, towards the bottom, I guess. I don't know. Was it 111, 112? I haven't done the averages, the mean averages. What would help that out, wouldn't it? But anyway, there's the data sets. Similar to last year, no worse. It's the same data sets side by side, if you just wanted to compare. This is the Tesla Powerwall data, which is the in and out. So yellow is in, green is out, and the round trip efficiency is shown in blue. This is our normal chart showing the amount of kilowatt hours we sent back to the grid. Not very many in December, November or October, so fairly good management of that. I've said before, but just to repeat for those that are new, we don't get paid for export. We're not on an export tariff. We're on the original FIT payment, the golden FIT, as some people refer to it. So we get deemed export. So 50% of what we generate is classed as deemed export, which is not a great amount. It's about £130 a year in total. And we would be better off on an export tariff if we exported more. But currently we can't export from our Tesla Powerwall because we haven't got that facility. And I think that will change going forward. We're looking at getting a second Powerwall to add to our existing one and going on the Gateway 2, which we were waiting for the DNO to respond to say how much or how little export capacity we'll have. Wait and see on that one. I'll keep you informed. This is from the grid. So December, a big old month now. That would be when the air source heat pump is now being used, plus we're on an intelligent tariff. So you can see there from July onwards when the heat pump went in. So August, September is fairly typical, but October, November, December using a lot more electricity because of the heat pump. So this chart looks at the number of days where we've had less than 100 watt hours of grid pull. October we had 11, and unsurprisingly none in November or December. This is our yearly totals for the house over the past 4 years, 5 years even, John, 2019 through to 2023. And you can see fairly sort of similar. These are taken from the Tesla Powerwall app, and I've got some more charts showing the same data set but in different cuts. Home usage, as you can see, there is an increase, but when you start looking at the percentage increase, it's actually not that much. So between 2022 and 2023, the increase is just 8%. So you know, I think to have worked it out from memory. So not a massive increase over what we had the previous year. And again, that'll be car charging and probably more likely the air source heat pump. This is again from the Tesla Powerwall app showing solar offset as a percentage of our total house usage. Quite interesting to see. I like having different cuts of the same data sets because you can see different things within the data. And it also shows you any anomalies or anything that, hang on a minute, this doesn't look quite right. As you can see there, it's all fairly static and as expected. This shows you the eddy, which heats our hot water. When I say heats our hot water, we don't really use it now, with the air source heat pump being more efficient. One unit of electricity can produce 4 units of heat, whereas with the eddy, it's 1 to 1. So if we have excess solar and we've got nowhere to put it, then I will heat the hot water with it. But generally, as you can see there in January, and it wasn't used very much. Sneak peek of January there. Don't pretend you didn't see it. December, nothing. November, 4, and then October, 10. So it's gradually reducing in usage. These are the cars. So the Zoe, 22 kilowatt Zoe, and the Tesla Model 3. We haven't had any problems. We've had Cleveley in to do servicing and things like that. So that's fine. All, you know, general routine stuff. We've had a few of the suspension components changed in both cars because the bushings were wearing, but again, just general wear and tear. Brakes, still fine. Brake pads, nowhere. So yeah, all good there. So that's our totals for 2023. Again, very cheap motoring, really, over the course of the year. Here's our fit payments. So this is the first chart which shows the solar generation of the two arrays over the years, year by year. So cracking year in 2020 and pretty good year, second best year in 2023. So it just goes to show that when you look at the data, your memory is sometimes lets you down. It has been a very sunny 2023, well, certainly for us. And that's reflected in the feed-in tariffs, where we've managed to... I was just looking at the data there. I wonder why 2020 is more generation, but less feed-in tariff. Don't quite understand that. I need to have a look at that. I'm sure there's some obvious explanation that I'm overlooking. But yeah, a really good year for fit payments, so almost £3,000 in fit payments. I've said before, this all goes back into new things in the house, like the heat pump, the second battery, what have you. This chart just shows the quarterly fit payments, broken down over year by year as well for interest. And then finally, just for complete openness and clarity, is our electric bills for the last three, well, since 2011, but we're really interested in the 2023 ones and the last 3 months. So you can see the winter bills. No gas, as I said, so purely everything is electric. So £170 a month, £180 a month, £88 a month for everything electric. And I thought I'd just leave you with this little ditty. It's about 30 seconds long. It's from a Ripple, and they send this to every Ripple owner, 900 or so, from Craig Faffa, just wrapping up 2023. So any questions, drop them down in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and I will see you on the next video.
All right, take care. Bye.